Hey guys, welcome to the next video on Scala tutorial for beginners. From this video, we will start our object-oriented programming journey in Scala. And we will start with Scala classes. Now, first of all, what are classes? So classes in Scala are the blueprint for creating object. And one object we have already seen, which is this object. So when you use this keyword before any name, this means that this is a singleton class, and that means that you cannot create an instance out of this object. But classes enables us to create an object out of them. So let's see how we can create the classes in Scala. So in order to create a class in Scala, you just need to use a keyword class and the class name, for example, user. And that's it. So this is a fully qualified class. And when you want to create an instance or object out of this class, you can just write, for example, var user is equal to new user. And that's it. So this is how you can create an instance out of class. So when we run this code, it will not give any error to us. Now let's go further and let's create a constructor in this class. So in order to create a constructor, you can just directly give these parentheses, and inside these parentheses, you can define your constructor variables. So for example, var and your variable name, for example, name, and then the data type, which is a string, for example. And let's say we want to give one more variable, which is age, and this will be an int. And as soon as you do this, you can see error appears here, because now we need to initialize our constructor and we need to give the name and the age of this user. So for example, name is Max and the age is 28. And now this error is gone. So now when you define some constructor in your class which takes some input, you need to give that input to your class, which is like this. Now if you see this constructor carefully, I have defined these variable with var here, right? And this var means that we can override the value of name and age here. So first of all, let's say we can just use this user object, and then we can access the name member variable, and this user.name will give you Max because we have initialized this member variable with this initial value. So let's see what is the content of this user.name using print line. And when I run this code, it prints Max. In a similar way, when you use user.age here, it's going to print 28. Now, this var in front of this variable means you can override the value of name because it's mutable. So we can do something like this. So user.name is equal to, this time we can give another name. So for example, Tom to the name, and we can also change the age of this user, and this time we are going to give 22 age here. And now when we just print the value of this user.name and user.age, then it's going to give you this result. So now this value and this age is overwritten by the new name and new age. Now on the other hand, when you use val here instead of var, and also val in front of age, then you can see that you cannot override the value of name and age. And this is going to give you this error, and this error says reassignment of val, right? So reassignment of val is not possible because it's immutable. So whenever you use val here, you cannot override the value of these member variable. You can also define one member variable as val and other variable as var, for example. This is totally allowed and logical also. So you can override the value of age now, but you cannot change the value of name. Now you may also ask that why do we need this val or var? We can directly say name string and age int here instead of using var and val in front of them. And as soon as you do this, you will see that this is going to give you an error. And this error is value name is not a member of user. So whenever you define a constructor like this, you need to give var in front of your member variable or val in front of your member variable. Now you may have also learned that a member variable can be a private or a public member. So for example, we want to define this name as a private member variable. We can just add this keyword private in front of this member variable. And now this gives us error because we have defined this member variable private. You cannot access this member variable outside the class. So you can access this member variable inside the class, but outside the class, this will give us this error that you cannot access this member variable outside the class. So how we can access this member variable inside the class? You can just add these two curly brackets in front of your class definition, and then you can define a method here. So for example, we define a method called print name here. So I'm going to just write println, and inside the parentheses, I'm going to just write name here and then close this curly bracket. And then I can use this method here in order to access the value of name. And when I run the code, this is going to give me the value of name. And I don't even need this print line now because this is printing the name value from here. So when I run the code again, you will see it will print max and the age 28. So what we have learned today, we have learned about var and val and default values. So when we define a member variable as var, then getter is available for this and setter is available for the member variable. When you define a variable as val, then getter is available for this kind of value, but setter is not available for this kind of value because you cannot reset the value of the immutable variable, right? And by default, when you don't give any value in front of your member variable, then neither getter is available nor the setter is available for your member variable. So you cannot set the value of this member variable if this var or val is not there, and you cannot even get the value of this member variable if this var and val is not used in front of your member variable. And at last, you have seen if you define a member variable as private, then you cannot use this member variable outside the class. So inside the class, you can see it's valid to use this member variable, but outside the class, it's not allowed. So this is how you can define a simple or basic class in Scala. I hope you've enjoyed this video. In the next video, we will dive more into classes and object-oriented programming in Scala. So stay tuned and please rate, comment, and subscribe, and bye for now.